Mumbai is powerless. That is a big story we're tracking right now on India Today. But what we're picking up at the moment is that within 45 minutes to about an hour, there will be restoration of power supply. But we can't tell unless it actually really happens. Remember, Mumbai has got very tall skyscrapers. The city of Mumbai depends on the power supply. With this electricity failure, we're still trying to pick up how many people are stuck in elevators in these sky rises. And, you know, hospitals will require power supply, especially during the COVID-19 times as well. Mustafa joins us from the Maximum City, joining us for the very latest. Mustafa, I think about 8 years ago was the last time when this kind of a power blackout happened in Mumbai. At the moment, Mumbai cars would be going through mayhem, given the fact that the entire city, the way it is laid out. All right, hold on. We're getting some reactions coming in. Listen in.
Ji.
All right, we'll get those reactions just about a bit. But Mustafa, what I was saying here is this, that the last time that the power supply cut happened in this particular fashion was about 8 or 9 years ago. And Mumbai is a city, the way it is laid out, it runs on power. Whether it is the metros, whether it is the skyscrapers, the high rises, the closed elevators. I mean, one can only imagine what people must be going through with this kind of a power cut. But what we're picking up at the moment is within 45 minutes to an hour, there will be some sort of a restoration. Is that confirmed, Mustafa?
Well, we don't have any such information. What we can tell you is that the BMC has come out with a statement. The Municipal Commissioner of Mumbai, IS Chahal, has said that all hospitals have a power backup system. They will be conducting out for 8 hours the power backup, which they have usually as kept an emergency, with which the ICU in the hospitals can be read. A big question was being raised on the ICU beds being operational, on the hospitals being operational in Mumbai and COVID patients getting affected. So all the hospitals who contact their respective SW and transport garage officers to get enough supply of diesel for at least 8 hours so that there is no power failures in hospitals, especially ICUs. In case of any issues, there will be a disaster control which will be providing SET vehicles handy with next 1 hour power failure. If it continues, then there is a mobile DG set also available for 1 or 2 hours which can last for an hospital. So this is a message which the BMC has come out with so that there is no panic about the hospital. Yes, we can't deny the fact that there will be inconvenience, but the essential service or the ICUs or the oxygen supplies at least will not be affected. That is what the BMC is saying at this point of time, Chaiti.
All right, so BMC says that essential supply ICUs are not getting impacted at the moment, perhaps because they have a power backup. But how long will that power backup even last, Mustafa, is the big question. One. Number two, you've got skyscrapers. People would be in elevators, you know, suddenly there's a power failure. You know, most of the times they get rescued, but there are some times where people really get stuck endlessly. What are we picking up on that front? I mean, there's just so many skyscrapers in Mumbai.
Well, yes, it's a huge city, Chaiti, and there is, you can say that we'll have to wait and hear the updates as it comes, but there are a lot of things which can be mitigated with the increasing technology, like the elevators and the lifts, which automatically reach to the ground floor and the doors are open in case of an electricity failure. It doesn't get stuck at one place, but yes, there can be untoward incidences which one can't deny. So we'll have to wait and see what kind of updates it's coming. Nobody is denying the fact that it's a big problem, it's a big inconvenience, and if it doesn't dissolve, then it will be a huge price to pay for the Mumbaikers who must be wanting to travel or must be admitted to hospital or wanted to go from one place to other back.
And tell me, what are the updates coming in from the Dalal Street? The stock market would be impacted because of this?
Yeah, we'll have to wait, Chaiti, and find out the updates as to whether the stocks, how they have opened up and whether it has been affected. But if it is affected, it will be a temporary thing, because what we know is the fact that this is some technical problem which has taken place. Yes, it will. There's a lot of questions as how things function. But at this point of time, we'll have to first focus that to when it is getting repaired. But there can be a small reaction seen at the stock markets operational on Monday with the electricity failure. And we don't know whether the BSE in fact is working, whether they have a power backup and things like that. Back to you.
All right, Mustafa. So Mustafa does not have those updates at the moment, but we will go along the way and get more updates right there from Mustafa. But Mustafa, I see you are standing by at the BMC office, if I'm not mistaken. The BMC's official statement, is that out at the moment? And what do they have to say about Mumbai suburbs, South Mumbai? I mean, of course, Thane and all those districts do not fall under the BMC, but give us some updates for those viewers as well.
Yeah, we are at the center railway office. Just the CPRO will be briefing in some time about the trains update. The center railway has been affected due to the power outage. We are here to get an update on that. The BMC has said that the hospitals, which is the essential service, will not be affected. But yes, there are a lot of
cutting straight across to some reactions that are coming in. Listen in.
5 minutes se jo hai grid failure ki wajah se जो सबअर्बन ट्रेन्स है वो रुकी है. हमें अभी अभी इन्फॉर्मेशन जो मिली है 10:55 से हार्बर लाइन जो है सीएसएमटी से पनवेल के बीच में जो हार्बर लाइन है उसे रिस्टोर किया गया है और वहाँ पे ट्रेनें जो है स्लोली हम रिज्यूम कर रहे हैं. जो मेन लाइन है सीएसएमटी से कसारा और सीएसएमटी के करजत के बीच में ट्रेनें अभी भी खड़ी है. जहाँ सेक्शन में ट्रेनें हैं वहाँ पर हमारा जो क्रू है ट्रेन का वो ट्रेन के अंदर अनाउंसमेंट कर रहा है. जो पैसेंजर्स है उनको जाके हम लोग बता रहे हैं कि आपको ट्रैक पर उतरने की जरूरत नहीं है, पैनिक होने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. जहाँ पे स्टेशन पर ट्रेनें खड़ी है वहाँ पे हमारा स्टेशन स्टाफ है, सिक्योरिटी पर्सनल्स है, वो लोगों को अपील कर रहे हैं कि इस डिफ़िकल्ट टाइम में हमें कोऑपरेट कीजिए. और वो जो ग्रिड फेलियर है उसमें कंटिन्यूसली जो है हमारे इंजीनियर्स कंटिन्यूसली टच में है. जहाँ से हमें इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मिल रही है वहाँ पे ग्रिड फेलियर होने के कारण जो है ये इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सप्लाई जो बंद हुई है वो रिस्टोर करने के लिए जल्दी से जल्दी जो है कोशिश की जा रही है.
ट्रेनें इस वक्त हॉल्टेड है और क्या कुछ इंतजाम किए जा रहे हैं जो यात्री फंसे हुए उनको वहीं रुकने कहा गया है कि कुछ अल्टरनेटिव?
देखिए सीएसएमटी कसारा करजत सेक्शन में लगभग 30 से 35 ट्रेनें जो है सबअर्बन खड़ी है और एक मेल एक्सप्रेस खड़ी है. जहाँ पे जैसे मैंने बताया कि सेक्शन में जो ट्रेनें खड़ी है वहाँ पे जो हमारा क्रू है, गार्ड है, मोटरमैन है, लोगों को अपील कर रहे हैं कि ट्रैक पर उतरने की जरूरत नहीं. जहाँ पे स्टेशन पर ट्रेनें खड़ी है वहाँ पे स्टेशन स्टाफ है, बाकी सिक्योरिटी पर्सनल्स है, वो जाके लोगों को अपील कर रहे हैं, अनाउंसमेंट कर रहे हैं कि पैनिक होने लायक कोई सिचुएशन नहीं है. एक ग्रिड फेलियर का इशू है, इसमें कोई ओएचई टूटा नहीं है, कोई ईएमयू इलेक्ट्रिक मल्टीपल यूनिट ट्रेन है उसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. तो अभी जैसे मैंने बताया कि हार्बर लाइन हमने धीरे धीरे रिस्टोर करना शुरू कर दी है, वैसे ही मेन लाइन भी धीरे धीरे रिस्टोर हो जाएगी.
CPRO of Central Railway has given out a statement right there. Pankaj Upadhyay is joining us from one of the trains right there at the stations in Mumbai. Pankaj, trains coming to an absolute screeching halt on a standstill. Of course, the lifeline of the city getting impacted due to the power cut. What are you picking up?
So the government has said that it's going to take around 45 minutes to an hour before the situation normalizes. But of course, people who were inside the local trains have a complaint here that no announcement was made, and that even though while on one hand the railway officials might be saying that several announcements have been made and that the passengers are being apprised of the latest situation, what I'm seeing on ground zero is completely different. Many people are panicky. Now, remember, these are the essential services class who've been allowed inside the local trains. They travel on a daily basis. But it's due to lack of announcement and perhaps due to lack of efforts by the various agencies on ground zero that such a situation has arisen, that this is what is happening on ground zero. I was talking to many people, many passengers, and they were maintaining that since no announcements have been made, they do not know as to when the grid failure is going to be corrected. What is going to be the next course of action? आप मुझे बताइए यहाँ पर कुछ अनाउंसमेंट वगैरह हुई थी?
नहीं, कुछ भी नहीं. हम लोग ने इनको पूछा तभी हमको मालूम पड़ा कि ऐसा प्रॉब्लम हुआ है करके. एटलीस्ट बताना तो चाहिए ना हम लोग को.
आप क्या बताएंगे, कुछ अनाउंसमेंट वगैरह हुए आपको, कुछ बताया गया है?
जी नहीं, कुछ भी अनाउंसमेंट हुआ नहीं है. 10:08 से यहाँ पे ट्रेन रुकी है और बस ऐसे ही बोल रहे हैं, कुछ बोला ही नहीं है.
तो आप आगे क्या करने वाले, आगे क्या करेंगे आप लोग, कब तक इंतजार करने वाले, क्या उम्मीद कर रहे हैं, कुछ बताएंगे?
बट कुछ बोल ही नहीं रहे ना कि कैसे जाना है, क्या करना है.
So Chaiti, this is ground zero situation where the passengers who are inside are saying that no announcements have been made. They do not know what is going to happen next, and that is the reason why we are seeing that many people, which are now of course in the local trains, there are many old women as well, there are elderly citizens as well, now many have to go to the hospitals as well. There are many people who are working in blood bank in hospitals as well. They are all stuck. They say that no announcements have been made, and that is the reason why they are so panicky. Here we are getting you a ground zero situation as it's happening. old women are getting down here. Oh, even though I see some of the railway police present here, but people perhaps were expecting a little more. Even now, they are saying they do not know what is the next course of action, while the railway authorities on one hand are saying that they are working around the clock and perhaps things are going to normalize in some time. But in Ground Zero, the situation is completely different.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.